हेलो सर।
हेलो रे मैडम।
हेलो मैडम।
हाँ सर।
ಸರ್ ಇನ್ನ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ರೀ, ನಾನು ಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ.
ಏನ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಸರ್?
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರ ಹೆಸರು ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ,
ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್.
ಇವ್ರ ಸಿದ್ದನಗೌಡ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಸರ್ ಇನ್ನ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ.
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಜೂಮ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಐಡಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸರ್. ಹಾ, ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸರ್, ನಾ ಕಳಿಸಿದ್ದು. ಹಾ ಸರ್, ವಾಟ್ಸಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ರಿ ಸರ್? ಓಕೆ ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಕೇಳಾಕತ್ರಿ ಸರ್? 1 2 3 4 5 6 ಕೋಡ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಹಾ 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 ಅದೇ 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 ಸರ್, ಅದೇ. ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ? ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಇರತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ.
ಅಲ್ರಿ, ಅದು ಲಿಂಕ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಓಪನ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದಲ್ಲ.
ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಸರ್, ಅದು ಲಿಂಕ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಜೂಮ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ದು ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸರ್, ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಓಪನ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡತ್ತೆ. ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಅದೇ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ.
ಮೇಡಮ್, ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ
ಸರ್. ಸರ್, ಅದು ಲಿಂಕ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಜೂಮ್
ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ನೀವು ಏನು ಸೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ?
ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ದ ಲಿಂಕ್, ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ದ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ.
ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇದೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಅದು
ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇದೆ ಸರ್.
ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನ ಕಳಿಸಿ ನೋಡಿ.
ಅದು ಬೇಡ, ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸರ್, ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇದೆ, ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಲಿಂಕ್.
ಜೂಮ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ,
ಜೂಮ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ.
ಇಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ ಸಲ ಕಳಿಸಿ ಬಿಡ್ರಿ, ಬರೀ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಅದು ಲಿಂಕ್
ಸರ್. ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷ, ನಾ ಕಾಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷ.
हेलो मैडम हेलो मैडम अस्मा मैडम
सर मैडम कॉल मारतिदारे
ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಆಡಿಯೋ ಅಂತ ಲೈವ್ ಅಂತ ಐತಿ ಇದು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಟ್ ಇನ್ವೈಟ್
ಸರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್
ಸರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್
ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್
ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ ಕೋ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗೈತಿ
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ ಕೋ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತಾ
ನೀವು ಸೆಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್
ಟಾಪ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ
ಸರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್
ಹಲೋ
ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಸರ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಮೇಡಮ್
ಅವ್ರ ಕಾಲ್ ನಾಗ ಮಾತಾಡತಾರ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ
ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು ನೋಡ್ರಿ
ಸರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್
ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಇದಾರೆ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಲ್ಲ ಸೌಂಡ್
ಬಿಸಿ ಫೋನ್
ಹಲೋ ಹಲೋ
ಹಲೋ
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್ ಸಿದ್ದನಗೌಡ ಸರ್ ಪಟೇಲ್ ಸರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್
ಹಲೋ
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್
ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಬರಲ್ತ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀನಿ
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್ ಚಂದ್ರಕಾಂತ್ ಸರ್
ಸರ್
ಸರ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಎರಡು ಇದೆಲ್ಲ
ಸರ್ ನಮ್ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಏನು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಮೇಬಿ ಅವ್ರು ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ಬೇಕು ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಮ್ದು ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡ್ರಿ
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಈಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೈತೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ನಿಮ್ ಚಂದ್ರಕಾಂತ್ ಅದರ
ಸರ್ ಹಾ ಸರ್
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಸರ್ ಸರ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ನಾವು ಸರ್ ಈಗ ಸರ್ ಮೂರ್ತಿ ಸರ್
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಶಂಕರಗೌಡ ಸರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಶಂಕರಗೌಡ ಪಟೇಲ್ ಸರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಅವ್ರ ಫೋನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಸಿ ಇದಾರೆ
ಹಲೋ ಚಂದ್ರಕಾಂತ್ ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ
ನಮ್ದು ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ
ಅವ್ರ ಹೆಡ್ಫೋನ್ ಹಾಕೋಕ್ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ ಸರ್ ಈಗ
ಹಲೋ
ಹೆಡ್ಫೋನ್ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೆಡ್ಫೋನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ
ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ನನಗೆ ಏನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಂದು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ
அஸ்மா மேடம் அஸ்மா மேடம்
சார் ஹேட்ரி
அவருக்கு சார்க்கு அல்லி மியூட் மாட்கொண்டிருத்தாரு
இல்ல சார் மியூட் இல்ல அவர்து
அல்ல அல்லி மாட்கொண்டிருத்தாரு அவரு அதுக்காக கேடசல்ல அவரு அல்ல நந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அங்க ஆகிட்டல்ல அல்ல அன்மியூட் மாட்கொள்ள கேட்ரி ஆகுது
हाँ सर हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हेलो सर अनम्यूट आगे दे निम दो अदो म्यूट आगे दे अनम्यूट मार कोली सर 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 केलता इधर ना ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ದು ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ನಮ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಝೂಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ದು ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದು ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸರ್
ಫಸ್ಟ್
ಸೈಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್
ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಶೇರ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತದೆ ನೋಡಿ
ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಶೇರ್ ಅಂತ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸರ್
ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್
ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಗೆ
ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಕ ಹೇಳಿ ಸರ್
ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಹಾ ಹಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಡ್ ಫೋನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸರ್ ಹಾ ಅದು ಆನ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಸರ್ ರೆಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸರ್ ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಏನ್ ಬಂತು ಸರ್ ಹಲೋ ಚಂದ್ರಕಾಂತ್ ಸರ್
ಹಲೋ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ
ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್
ಸರ್ ನೀವೇ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಲ್ಲ
ಚಂದ್ರಕಾಂತ್ರಿ
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Om Sri Guru Basavalingaya Namah. Om Sri Dhanvantaraya Namah. Good morning to all. Dwar Malko, welcome to this session. With the blessings of His Holiness Sri Sriman Niranjana Pranama Swarupi Guru Mahanta Swamiji and under the guidance of our beloved principal Dr. K.C. Das sir, we from the Department of Shalya Tantra Sri Vijayamantresha Ayurvedic Medical College Ilkal conducting this 12th webinar lecture and today's topic is a parasurgical approach in the management of pilonidal sinus and today's guest speaker is Dr. Siddhan Gowda Patil professor department of shalya tantra ayurveda mahavidyalaya and the hospital Hubballi it's my great pleasure to welcome and introduce our today's guest speaker Dr. Sidhangoda Patil sir. I heartily welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I'll give the brief introduction regarding the Dr. Sidhangoda Patil, Dr. Sidhangoda Patil sir. Sir has completed his undergraduate from Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya Hubli in 2002 and MS in Shalya Tantra in SDM Ayurvedic College Hassan in 2005. And a PhD from same college, Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Bengaluru in 2015. Sir has wide experience in academics and organized various free medical camps and organized and delivered various lectures on health awareness programs about lifestyle in anorectal disorders and awarded as the best boy of the college at the Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya Hubli in 2001. And awarded a certificate of appreciation of Giant Group of Hubli City for outstanding service in the March 2010. And sir has also awarded as a Basavarashtriya Prasasti in the Silver Jubilee celebration in 2013. Sir has conducted various live surgical workshops, various papers in state and national level conferences and seminars, and work as a resource person for various programs and various seminars. Sir has given the Kshara Sutra training programs for Ayush doctors and health education workshop for teachers of taluka level at Dharwad district. And also sir has given the series of talk in Akashwani Dharwad and KLE Dhawani FM radio. And sir has a special skills in almost all the parasurgical procedures and operated more than 10,000 cases in anorectal disorders. And also developed the good skills in close reduction techniques in the fracture. And sir presently working as a postgraduate department of Shalya Tantra Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya Hubli and recognized as a guide for the PG student or PG scholar and recognized as a guide for recognized as a PhD guide also. Okay, and sir has a very cute family, married Dr. Shobha. And blessed with the two kids, Shreyas Gowda and Spurti. And I wish you all the best, sir. all the students are waiting for your sweet lecturer. Apart from this, I also extend my welcome to our beloved principal, sir, and all of faculty members of our college, and the PG scholars, and UG students, and the practitioners from the ILKAL. And heartily welcome Dr. Sidhangoda Patil sir, and I'll hand over to Dr. Sidhangoda Patil to continue this session, sir. Sir, please continue, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful introduction and welcome, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Continue, sir. Please.
Sahasraksham ganadisham swagruncha sarasatim janakam janayatrincham adhyam sarvam pranamyaham. Hello, sir.
Sir,
adhyam sarvam pranamyaham. Very good morning to one and all. First of all, I submit my humble pranamas to the lotus feet of Lord Dharmantri. And I recollect the surgeon, Ayurvedic surgeon, and great person who have elaborated and who has elaborately explained and astonished so many principles, including Bhagna Chikitsa, the plastic surgery, and who explained everything about the dead body dissection, none other than the father of surgery, Shushruta, at this juncture. And also, I remember my gurus, Dr. Prasanna Narasimha Rao sir, Dr. Hemant Kumar sir, and Dr. Toshikani for their blessings and guidance throughout my academic career. A respected Principal K.C. Das sir, a principal of SVM Ayurvedic Medical College, ILKAL, and a person who with always smiling face and encouraging and helping hand, Dr. Prakash Tariwal sir, a respected HOD, Dr. Sidling Swami sir, and Prabhudev sir, and dear friend Dr. Chandrakant Budni, and dear friend Dr. Asma, and important person Dr. Arvind Kannoli, who was a friend in our institute when he was doing our postgraduate here. And all the respected staff of SVM Ayurvedic Medical College, and also all the respected managing committee members of SVM Ayurvedic College, and all the webinar live webinar viewers and respected students. It's an opportunity for me to present our views and our experience to share with among you all. Today the topic allotted was pilonidal sinus, especially the pilonidal sinus. In this, the parasurgical procedures are well known and the bread and butter of our Ayurvedic surgeons like Kshara Karma and Kshara Sutra, which I am going to highlight and share with you all. When you look into this first slide of this one, pilonidal sinus word, pila is a hair, nidus is a nest, sinus is a blind tract. Once you see the single, maybe presented with the single opening, or maybe presented with the abscess, or maybe presented with the discharging sinus. When you see the cross section here, the second slide, which give you about within this skin and below that within the fatty area, a sac-like cavity will be formed by a tuft of hairs, which is very difficult. So though it looks to be a simple disease, but when you go for the management, it is known for its recurrence and it becomes a headache for a doctor as well as a surgeon also. So it becomes a important disease for the discussion point today with our golden principles. Why the pilonidal sinus is important? Because it is a commonly come across disease in the OPD. Though the incidence is less, the recurrence is more. The more referrals to Ayurvedic surgeon from most of the modern surgeons, they refer, because once they operate, it is known to recur. Hence, they become a headache. It is become a headache for them, and they refer to Ayurvedic surgeons. Recently, we are getting the most of the cases from even a modern surgeons also. We should feel proud for the our science, which has given an excellent result in such area. Because of the high recurrence rate, it has become a headache. I already explained. Upper end of Kshara Sutra in the management of this pilonidal sinus, as well as another important disease called as fistula in ANO, where with the help of this Kshara Sutra, we could able to manage these two things successfully. A month back, I received a case from Saudatti, a general surgeon from the district hospital, Dr. Rajshekar Ajarvi, who referred a case to me with the complaints of recurrent discharging sinus at the postnatal area, who referred this case when we examined previously operated by somebody else with the scar. The person was become a headache. It was become a headache for him. And he came to us and he asked the question, whether you have a solution for this, sir. This was his first question. I gave an answer. If you have a patient, you will definitely give a solution for this. With this, he satisfied. We could able to successfully manage this case. I will share some of the pictures of that particular patient. I will go on sharing the some of the my experience, which we did in our last 15, 16 years of practice. I am going to share with you all. So this has become a most important disease for us. A sinus is a blind tract extending from the skin to the deeper tissue, which is lined by the granulation tissue or epithelium. Here, the most important thing, the difference between the pilonidal sinus or a sinus as well as fistula in ANO. Fistula is a communicating tract. Once you pass a probe, you will get another opening. Due to some false closure also, you will a thin membrane may be there. Whereas here, you can't able to reach another end. Only it is a blind end. So it is extending from the skin to the deeper tissue, and which is lined by a granulation tissue or epithelium. The main important thing here in this disease is broken off hair, which tend to collect in the natal cleft, which is the postnatal area, end of the sacrum, end of the spine, where you have a interdigital area we call in between the buttocks, where a dimple may be present. In that, because of the rub, the fallen hair enters into that, it forms a tuft of hairs and forms a pilonidal sinus there. It is like a tunnel or a sinus or a tract. It may be filled with the pus, causing the formation of cyst, which you can able to see in this diagram. A tract is there, a blind end, a cavity is formed in that, the pus and the hair is there. It is a sinus tract, it is a hair, the fluid collected, a cyst, in total you call it is a cyst. It is embedded in the fatty tissue of the postnatal area or a postdigital area. The word is derived from the Greek word. Pila is a hair, nidus is a nest. It is a nest of hairs at a particular part. And the synonyms for this is, it is also called as a G bottom, a driver's disease. in the Second World War, the soldiers had a very recurrent and rampant effect of this, because they used to drive the jeep, and with the long standing and the more time they used to travel, because of that they developed the condition, hence the name it was called as a jeep bottom or jeep driver's disease or the driver's bottom. It was very commonly termed even today also. The commonest site in this is a postnatal, what we call as a sacral region between the buttocks. It is the most common area which we could able to get the cases. Apart from this, the other areas like umbilicus, maybe in the axilla or mid thigh amputation stump, post amputation in case of TAO and other things, or a diabetic gangrene, where you also you get in the mid thigh amputated stump also you will get. Even in suprapubic region, many a times the post-operative cases of suprapubic aspiration of the urination, sometimes it forms a sinus also. An interdigital area is a very common, especially in barbers, which you get could able to get it is interdigital area. These are the different pictures which I sharing here is the umbilicus and the interdigital are a web space, what we commonly call. How it will be at the postnatal, you see here there is a postnatal, here there is a dimple, a punctum, an opening is there in the postnatal area, which you can able to see opening on the skin surface. You can see area where sinus may be formed is a very common. Once you take the cross section, it will be appear like this. Or the bone, there is a fat tissue on that, there is a cavity, in that cavity the pus and the pila or a hair is there, and opening at the external, and you can sometimes see the opening also. And this again said, there are two important theories, the acquired theory and the congenital theory. Earlier what was understood was the hair was grown inside, but it is wrong. There is no hair follicle, there is no hair grown inside the cavity. It is an acquired completely. Presently what we study is, it is an acquired condition, it is an infectious acquired condition at the postnatal area. It is very clear. When you go for the incidence, at 26 patients out of 1 lakh population, this is what the incidence of this pilonidal sinus. It is rare before puberty and after the age of 40. It is the second and third decade is very commonly seen disease, because this is a age where you can use commonly vehicles, riding is very common, and maintenance of the improper maintenance of the particular part is also important, and other activities are more. So second and third decade are the most important decades where you get this disease. Once you consider the gender, the male-female ratio, the males are significantly higher rate than the females. That's about 4:1 male is to female ratio. It is very common in hirsute persons, what we call it is a person who have a very rich hairs, a hirsute person. In those individuals is very common. The more common in Western world than Asian or Africans. Africans will have a very less, because once you see the pathology, a straight, strong, slender hair is important here, which penetrates. Whereas in Africans, it is a curly hair. You can't expect there to develop this one. So it is very important. These are the area and these are the persons who get this, and this is about all the incidents. There are some risk factors like sedentary occupations. The persons who, the clerks, a bank employees, they are commonly sitting for long duration, about 4 to 5 hours in a day. Due to constant sitting work nature, because of the pressure, constant pressure and the sweat, which will cause a fall of a hair at a particular part. And because of the fallen hair, due to sweat, due to the irritation, continuous sitting, the skin will be rubbed and shiny, which becomes thin, and the hair enters into that. So the sedentary occupants will be getting commonly this disease. They have become a risk factor. A positive family history of a hirsute, and third thing is an obesity. The obesity is also an important thing where you get commonly this disease. Local irritation is more in drivers, especially what I highlighted in the, hence it was called as a jeep drivers in the Second World War. This is a very commonly seen in drivers, continuously brake, clutch and other movements of the limb at particular part, and pressure over the back of the seat is very common. The person who have a deep natal cleft, they will also have this problem. These are the risk factors. the other things like the type of a hair, which is very thin, a thick hair with a straight and a broken hair enters into that particular part will cause this problem. The force of hair insertion into the subcutaneous tissue will also plays an a risk factor for this. The few persons, they are vulnerability of the skin are the three important causes for the pyelonephritis sinus, which becomes a risk factors. Vulnerability is because the thin shiny hair at that particular, because of the set which become the soft skin, which becomes a prone or a vulnerability for this disease. The contents of this pyelonephritis sinus, especially the hairs, dirty or debris, which you can able to see here, the cavity which contains pus and collection is you can able to see here. How it spreads, the direction of spreading of this pus is 93% which runs above and 7% on either side, which becomes a ramification which forms a cavity, abscess will be formed. These are the directions where you can able to expect in the postnatal area. How you can able to see on the section is the skin, the sinus tract will be there, the fluid, hair, this becomes a pyelonephritis cyst, which continuously, once it burst opens, continuously discharging. Or sometimes after the complete discharge, it becomes a dimple, a punctum or the opening at this particular postnatal area, you can able to see this. What is the pathogenesis? Once the hair is broken, the broken hair enters, the penetrates the skin, which will result into a dermatitis. And next it leads into an infection. Once it infection forms, there is a pustulase formation will be there at particular area. Once the pustulase formation and burst opens, it forms the sinus formation. Once the sinus formed, the hair gets stuck into the sinus by a negative pressure. One hair enters, it creates a negative pressure. Simultaneously, the second hair will enter, third hair, like this, multiple hairs enters, they become a tuft, a nest of hairs, and the sinus is a negative pressure, it will be the main cause for this tuft of hair is enters there. Further, it irritates and the granulation tissue formation taken place. Then the pus formation will be more accumulated at particular part when you have seen the previous slide. The multiple discharging sinuses may be there or a single opening, which I have shown in the first slide, multiple openings with the multiple discharging sinuses, or maybe a single opening can be appreciated here. In brief, there are intrusion of hair, the infection will there, then abscess will form. It results into a pyelonephritis sinus, a blind end sinus will be there. This is a cross section on this area. We can see the how the hairs are entered and forms a cavity in this sinus. The clinical features looking into this, they may be asymptomatic, there may be a chronic sepsis may be there, or sometime acute abscess, they come with the pain, swelling and tenderness with sometimes fever also. In this way, in three presentation, the patient may come to you. A discharge may be a serosanguinous or a purulent discharge may be there. A pain like a throbbing or persistent if it is a collection pus inside the abscess cavity. A tender swelling above the coccyx in the midline. Once you appreciate palpate, there is a fluctuation test will be appreciated in the primary abscess once it is formed. Either side of the midline, the secondary sinus may be there or primary sinus opening may be there in the center of the midline. A tuft of hairs may be seen in the opening of the sinus. Sometimes they are emerging out from the sinus. Many a times we have seen. I will show the pictures how we have taken out the tuft of hairs from the sinus. The recurrent infection may be there and the abscess formation may be there, which burst open, forming the recurrent sinus with the pain, discharge and discomfort. It is a very discomforting area. Many a times underclothes gets damp and wet, the patient is not comfort. Hence, it is very discomfort during the working hours. A pus discharge you can able to see here sometimes. A second picture, we have taken out the tuft of hairs with an artery. You can able to see the hirsute persons are very common. The complications, the most common complication is acute and chronic infections. Sometimes you may get acute or chronic infections will you get. The chronic pyelonephritis sinus may occasionally cause a sacral osteomyelitis.
osteomyelitis is a disease which neither gives a name and fame to the surgeon nor a name and fame. He is satisfied with the treatment of the surgeon. The same thing, osteomyelitis will result, and this is causing problem. This can be a morbid because of the high recurrence rate. As it is a recurrent, the patient is having the morbid because of the headache. He is getting a headache of this disease. He has become a fed up of this disease. So these are the complications. The causes for high recurrence rate may be a improper removal. For example, the patient once first time develops, he definitely visits to a general practitioner. He thinks that it is a simple abscess. Initially, he gives the antibiotics and painkillers. It will not subside. After the few days, he goes to him and he does IND there itself without doing anything. Simply it opens. He drains and he leaves it. And without taking out the whatever contents are there, the foreign body like hairs is leaving. This results in the recurrence. An entry of the new tuft of hairs, once you open up, you leave it, is also a chances of the getting the entry. Overlooking of the existing diverticulum, there also you are getting the chances of it is a diverticulum pouch is formed. Once the pouch is formed, definitely there is a collection. At again, it is a negative pressure, hair enters, it never becomes healed. The breakage of scar due to the irritation, the continuous sitting, the that is soft tissue, the skin due to this what we call it, the sweat and other things, continuous rub, which becomes a break, a scar will become and opening that enters the hair in that particular part. So these are the things which cause a recurrence rate of this one. How will you diagnose? Initially, when the patient comes, there is a swelling and discharge at a particular posterior area at the buttock region. On inspection, you will see there is a dimple or a punctum may be there opening. Sometimes there is a swelling, tender discolored area with a reddish one. Sometimes there is a skin opening with the hairs may be there. On palpation in the tender area, you could able to see in the abscess the palpation fluctuation. Sometimes a tender raised temperature may be there sometimes. Once you confirm this, it is a sinus, you go for probing test after investigation. The following investigations help you to go for probing. Without investigation, don't go for probing. You may contaminate it with many contagious diseases like HIV and HPSAG. These are the common things to screen out and go for the further procedures and examination. The important thing next for this is a what is the length, how the directions, what are the ramifications. By pushing some dye, you could able to take this sinogram. Sometimes with the some other soft tissue involvement, if it is there, you go for magnetic resonance imaging. This helps you to understand this area. And computerized tomographic scan also give, along with the soft tissue, you can go for any bony involvement. If it is there, it will go for. X-ray chest will help you to go for the chest X-ray, because many a times secondary to the pulmonary infection, pulmonary cox, sometimes you may get this disease. If that is there, if you treat the primary cause, pulmonary tuberculosis, you need not worry about this pile needle sinus. It itself will heal as the fistula in anal heals. The ultrasonography examination, the abdomen will play important role. If any abnormal pathology, abdominal pathology is related to that, or pelvic pathology, if it is related to that, you can go for screening for an ultrasonography examination of the abdomen and pelvis many a times. The differential diagnosis which are very commonly seen here are perianal abscess. In case perianal abscess, the site is very important. In the post-distal area, if it is there, it is definitely none other than the pile needle abscess. If it is apart from that in the perianal area, you need not worry. It is, you just exclude it. The fistula, it is a communicating tract from the perianal skin to the internal viscera. Whereas sinus, you can't able to see another opening once you probe it. Hidradenitis suppurativa, it is an infection. It is a subcutaneous skin infection which you could able to see. And this also sometimes it gets confused. It is a chronic skin disease that causes a painful bumps under the skin in the skin area. A perianal complications of the Crohn's disease. Crohn's disease, which is related to the GIT, where you, because of that, secondary to that, sometimes there is a perianal complications will develop, like a fissure and a fistula. In the same way, you can get confusion also. The folliculitis, a particular hair infection, that also you will get confusion. These are all the differential diagnosis you could able to take during the management and the final diagnosis of the perianal pilonidal sinus. What is the treatment? In acute phase, simple drainage of the pus. Chedana and Vedana is an important procedure where you can go for complete taking out of the collected pus and go for the proper medications. If you do it, it will heal sometimes if it is a very superficial one. If it is a deep, you can't manage this one. The definitive treatment, excision and primary closure done under general anesthesia or local anesthesia in the prone position, or you can go for a jackknife position. Prone position is a simple lie down with the prone position, whereas the jackknife position is prone position with something is kept behind the below the abdomen and you could able to elevate the buttocks. This is a jackknife position. All sinus tracts should be opened and unhealthy granulation tissue with the hairs are to be completely taken out. And the methylene blue is injected to the demonstrate the multiple tracts properly so that the injected and colored area to be taken out. Excision and skin grafting is an important treatment you can go for. Has got a high recurrence rate, so if they are not going for this, excision and skin graft is rejecting because of the recurrence rate. Excision with the Z-plasty is giving a good results, so what we can practice many a times. I will share my experience and my view in this when I had a discussion. Keratoxis excision through a semilateral incision and lateralized suturing of the wound away from the midline gives the good results also many a time they practice. Excision with the closure using the Limburg or the rhomboid buttock flap, it is also giving the good results. Bascom technique of excision through a lateral approach is a good method. Through a small lateral incisions, about 2 to 4 mm sized sinus is approached and the pus is drained out. The hairs are removed with the only minimal excision of the sinus. The cavity walls are excised. Lateral small wounds are either sutured or left open for spontaneous healing. A Z-plasty for a pilonidal sinus, which gives you, once you excise completely, because once the skin is taken out that particular part, you can't get the skin. Once you suture simply, there is a tension will be there. You can't get a proper closure of the wound. So you can go for Z type of incision. You give and you go for the surgery. When I joined the Hubli Ayurveda College in the year 2005 as an young surgeon in the department of Shalya Tantra, one company arranged a proctology one-day seminar at the Clarsin Hotel in Hubli. The guest speaker was a renowned surgeon from the Dharwad who had a discussion about this fistula and the pilonidal sinus. He has very beautifully explained everything, Z-plasty and everything. At the end, he narrated a persons who practice with some kind of thread. They do it and they'll end up in a complications called infection and other complications. Suddenly, I raised a question and I stand up and I asked that senior surgeon, respected sir, what is the management of this pilonidal sinus and what is the result? He explained nothing. What I explained till now, it is the management and Z-plasty is giving the good result. And second question from my side was, what is the recurrence rate, sir? Okay, it recurs. If it recurs, we will go for the second procedures. If it recurs second also, what is your answer to the patient, sir? Again, it is nothing can be done. It is known for the recurrence. But at the same time, I mentioned, respected sir, whatever you are highlighted about that thread land ups in the complication. I am an Ayurvedic surgeon. I am an Ayurvedic graduate. I have experience of this bread and butter of Ayurvedic surgeon in the Kshara Sutra and proctology, where we have a good solution in case of pilonidal sinus as well as fistula in ano. In case of superficial pilonidal sinus, you go for Kshara Sutra. In case of deep and multiple openings, you go for excision followed by Kshara Karma. You never get a single case of recurrence. 99% of success rate is there in this case. He surprisingly, he said, okay, if it is there, we will accept like that. I could able to draw the attention of all the surgeons there. in Hubli in the year 2005, which I could able to get an opportunity. So dear students, you always be proud of your science, and whatever treasure is there, try to explore it and educate the people who have a negative impact on our science and our treatment modalities. Be proud. And at the same time, when I joined here, though we learned most of the abdominal procedures in the SDM Hassan, I decided myself, Hubli is a center where you get multiple super specialists. So I have to restrict myself to the only proctology and anorectal conditions, so I will get a good name. So what I am doing, even though I know the many procedures of abdominal surgeries, I will not go for all those things. Last 16 years, I am doing all this proctology practice only. I am happy with my practice. I can proudly say that I am a proctologist and I am happy with my practice. So this jejunplasty, what they do is, even this good result, they encourage, they are getting, telling that it is an encouraging result. Still then they are getting the recurrence in this also. So Kshara Sutra and Kshara Karma is the ultimate treatment modalities where you get a good result. This is another important rhomboid limbar flap for a pilonidal sinus. Here also, with the multiple openings, or if you want to go for a proper closure, you can go for this procedure. Even this properly done also, there is every chance of recurrence. Only for the knowledge sake, I am explaining these procedures, and I am not practicing all these procedures because I am happy with my practice of this Kshara Sutra and Kshara Karma. The other non-operative treatment like regular shaving, a trimming of that particular part, maintaining the hygiene is very important, because natal cleft area to have a meticulous hair control is very important, because the cause is hair. So if you maintain the proper hygiene, if you not allow the hair to grow at particular part, you will not have this disease. The proper perianal hygiene, which is very important, the drainage of the abscess if occurs, and the proper medication is also plays an important role. So after knowing all these things, whatever is highlighted in our Ayurvedic text, the Acharya Susruta has elaborately explained, and he has dedicated two important chapters, one in Nidana, 10th chapter, and 17th chapter in the Chikitsa. He has elaborately explained about this one. The detailed description of this Nadi Rana in Nidana Samprati Lakshana is available in Susrut Samhita since 1500 BC. The Shalya or the foreign body enters the Twagadi Dhatus and leads to the Shalyaja Nadi Rana. We know it. It is considered as a Shalyaja Nadi Rana. Among the Nadi Rana out of eight which mentioned Susruta, it is one of the eighth Shalyaja, the foreign body which is causing this Rana. Ashtanga Hrudayakara explained five, he explains eight. Dvandvaja is extra thing. In that, apart from that, the Shalyaja Agantuja is important here. It persists due to the presence of Shalya like Bala. Bala is an important thing which continuously discharging sinus is seen at the particular area. Nirukti, Nadi Yadvahati Tenu Matatu Nadi, he explained this one. The Nadi Rana, it is a type of Dushtarana which manifests due to the untimely mismanagement of Rana Shopa. Since the Rana involves the deep tissues and forms a tract, it is termed as a Nadi Rana. Nadi is a tract, a flute-like area which tract created here. Named Nadi as it is an analogous to the tubular structure, a hollow structure in shape. He has given a simile in the 10th chapter, 10th quotation, Susruta and Nidananta. The excess Puya Srava will be there from the Rana, which involves the deeper tissues forming the tracks in the different directions, which I have shown in the previous slide. Hence, this is called as a Nadi, or when many Nadis are formed, it is called, it takes a Gati at a particular distance, which is explained by Ashtanga Sangraha in the Uttara Tantra, 34th chapter in the 27th quotation. Now, Nidana for this is, if an ignorant surgeon, if a person, a surgeon considered, ignores this or considers the Pakva Shofa as Apakva, if he delays, if a Pakva is there, if he is not going for Bedana and drainage of pus at a proper time, the pus is not drained properly, the Rona is having excessive Puya and it takes the direction at different levels, it forms a Nadi and it becomes a Nadi Rona. Pus involves and necroses the deeper tissues and forms a tract at a particular part. So patient does not follows the patya. If he follows and if he is not doing patya, if he takes an ahita ahara, if he doing improper vihara, definitely it results in the ahita vihara means a continuous driving is one of the vihara. Ahita ahara is that is a spicy and fried items. If you consume, definitely you will have a problem of this one. Sometimes bhagna rana upeksha, if you are doing improper management of bhagna rana, definitely it leads into a bhagna treated improperly. I have mentioned osteomyelitis, one of the deadly disease. It is a headache to the surgeon. He refers, one saying is that if you have an enemy friend orthopedic surgeon, you refer a case of osteomyelitis to him. In the same way, if you have an enemy friend, you refer a case of fistula or a pilon needle sinus to him, an allopathic surgeon. He will become headache and fed up with this disease. So it is becomes improper management and neglected case in case of improperly managed bhagna, sarvana bhagna, there the chances of getting, especially sarvana bhagna, which becomes a disease called as nadi rana. How to samprapti? The neglected pakva shofa leads into excessive puya formation. This affects the deeper tissues. This destroys the one ranasthanas, ashtasthanas, and formation of nadi rana. Nadi rana will be formed. This is what the samprapti. The Beda lake, the 8 types of Vedas highlighted by Sushruta, 5 types of Vedas highlighted by Ashtanga Sangra. See, he is also explained Agantuja or Shalyaja, and Sushruta also very particular about Agantuja or Shalyaja, which is a main, Agantuja is a Shalya is a main reason to manifest this sinus, Nadi Rana. Both are highlighted about this one, so it is a very important thing. What are the Lakshana? If the Shalya is Tvakadi Sthana is not removed, it leads to the formation of Nadi Rana. You have to take it immediately once it is lodged, so you can prevent the further manifestation of this age. Srava is Fenila, which is Matita, it is thick, Swachha, clear, sometimes Ushna and Rakta Mishrita. It is an infected, no doubt the Ushnata will be there, raise the temperature at that particular part once abscess is drained out immediately. The associated with the Satata Vedana, sometimes the patient is having throbbing pain if it is an abscess form, Nadi Rana abscess. If it is a Krutra Sadhya, if it is lodged completely, if you could not able to take out the foreign body. If you could able to take out the foreign body, it is not a Krutra Sadhya, it is Sadhya only. What is Chikitsa? He says, Nadinam Gatiman Visham Sestrena Utpatyam Karmavit Sarva Vranakramam Sarva Vranakramam Kuryat Shodhanam Ropanam. See, you have to first see the Nadi Gati, Nadi Nam Gati Manvish. You see the direction of the Nadi with the help of Eshana Yantra. In the Ashtavida Shastra Karma, he has highlighted about the Eshana Karma will be done in Ganapata Kashta. You see, you just simply slowly go inside. You should not put a pressure. You should not create a resistance. Once you get a resistance, you leave it. So he has highlighted in Ashtavida Shastra Karma, Eshana Yantra, with Eshana Yantra you find the Nadi, and after that with the help of Shastra you utpate, you take out that whole thing. After that you go for the Rana Chikitsa. What is the Rana Chikitsa? You go for Shodhana. After that Shodhana you go for Ropana. First is probe done, incised with the Shastra, subjected to Shodhana and Ropana. Ranava Chikitsa will be followed so that you will get a good result in this one. Shalyaja Nadi Rana Chikitsa, Vedana of the Shalya Marga, you have to take it completely. Shalya Nirharana, taking out the foreign body of the Bala or the hair. Shodhana of the Nadi Marga, Rana Shodhana and Rana Ropana using mixture of Tilakalka, Madhu and Grita. You can take Tilakalka, Madhu and Grita equal quantity. Or else you can go for Sarpir Madhutraihi. In the management of Sarvana Bhagna, what Sushruta highlighted in the third chapter of Chikitsa, Sarpir Madhutrahi, Sarune Bhagne, Sarpir Madhutrahi. Sarpi and Madhu, if you take equal quantity, it becomes excellent or more than any of the antiseptic ointment. It helps for the healing of this one. Taila prepared of kashayas like Udumbara, Karjura, Kapitta, Bilva, Vata, Udumbara, Palasha. All these drugs, Taila prepare and go on application daily with a pichu so that it will become healed. Another important Kshara Sutra in pilon needle sinus. Why Kshara Sutra? It is a very simple method. It is a safe method. It is compared to other procedures, it is less painful. You can go for OPD procedure. Here, the tuft of hairs comes out easily during the thread changing. A railroad technique, what you do is every time with the knot, the hairs are coming with the knot. No scope for further infection due to the presence of chara. Once you put a thread there, you are maintaining the patency of the tract. The continuous drainage will be there. Once the continuous drainage is there, you need not, you are not giving a chance to collect the pus there. Recurrence rate is very, very less or nil if you are done methodically, technically, with the properly. Unaffected routine of the sufferer. It is not affecting the routines of the individual, so it is a very important safe disease. What are the indication? In case of Nadirana, it is manifested in Krusha, Durbala, Biru, and Marmashrita. There they highlighted you go for Kshara Sutra. Kshara Sutra is used for treatment where Shastra is contraindicated, another indication for disease. Biru, Ruddha, Bala, Krusha, Marmasthita. In these individuals, you can go for, and where Shastra cannot be used, you can go for Kshara Sutra. How the preparation? It is to be taken with the surgical linen thread number 20, as Snuhi Kshira is used, Apamarga Kshara, and Haridna Churna. These are the drugs which you can go for preparation of this one. This is a thread, the collection of the Kshira and the Apamarga plant, whole Panchanga. And preparation, surgical linen thread, after that you can take the Haridra shown here. And after that, standard Kshara Sutra means you have to use this. pH value should be 9.6 to 10. A tensile strength is about 5 kgs. And expiry date 6 months from the date of manufacture. If you are properly preserved and if you are properly prepared and you are properly dried. If you are not done all these things, you can't keep it more than this stage. The gauge of the thread must be 14 to 16. You can measure this wire gauge meter. Procedure of Kshara Sutra. What are the preoperative evaluation is to be done? Very important other systemic problems. Written and informed consent, what you are doing, why you are doing, what is the result. Everything should be explained to the patient. A preparation of the part should be done at that particular part. Injection tetanus toxide 0.5 ml. intramuscularly in case of gluteal region. A lignocaine sensitivity test dose is important. 0.2 cc intradermally can be given prior to the surgery. These are the materials required which you can going to use for the procedures. The operative procedure, like a position, is a jackknife position or the prone position. Jackknife I highlighted. A prone position with something is kept below the abdomen and raised buttocks is the jackknife position. Anesthesia, what I prefer usually a local anesthesia. I will not be depending on any of the anesthetists because I had a better experience. Most of the anesthetists, they refuse sometimes due to they are not interested in some of the Ayurvedic procedures. Painting and draping is very important. Cleaning of the debris is very important. Removal of the visible hairs and debris with the pus. You can see this picture. The hairs are removed here. They're collected from the sinus tract. By probing, the tract is found. You have to Gatiman Vishya, what Sushruta highlights. Primary threading is inserted into the eye of the probe and passed through the tract. Probe is removed from the distal end of the tract, leaving behind the thread in the tract. Sometimes, usually we will not go. As a procedure, we are explaining this primary threading in this bilateral sinus. After this 3 days, you can go for Kshara Sutra. Routinely, what we do, as a primary thread only, we go for Kshara Sutra, we put. Kshara Sutra is tied firmly outside the tract and not should be outside. Till the tract is completely excised, Kshara Sutra is to be changed every week. This procedure is to be done. I am going to highlight about the procedure. The procedure of this one. The prone position which are given, preparation of that part, previously the hair are removed at the particular part. painting will be done. This is a pilonidal abscess. You can able to see here. This is a pilonidal abscess. The another opening was here. In the interdiscal below that buttock area.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Opening is here. The abscess is here.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Hello? Sir, video play karta illa. Hello.
Local anesthesia is given.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
At that particular part.
Hello, sir.
After that.
Hello, sir. Sir. Sir, Patil, sir.
The collected pus is drained completely. The tract is open completely. Then you have to.
Sir, Patil, sir. Hello, Patil sir.
Hi, madam.
Sir, Patil sir. Sir, aagta illa.
Hello, hello.
Sir, video play aagta illa.
ಹಲೋ ಮೇಡಮ್.
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಪ್ಲೇ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್.
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಸರ್, ಸೇಮ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಇದೆನಾ
ನೋಡಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಈಗ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಹೌದಾ
ಸರ್, ಮಿನಿಮೈಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ನ.
ಈಗ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಮೇಡಮ್?
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಪ್ಲೇ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಈಗ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಸರ್, ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇದೆ. ಸರ್, ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇದೆ.
ಮೇಡಮ್ ನೋಡಿ ಇವಾಗ.
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಪ್ಲೇ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ?
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ಫೈನ್.
ಇವಾಗ ಇದೆಯಾ
ಸರ್? ಹೋಯ್ತು.
ಓ ಮೈ ಗಾಡ್. ಇದು 8 ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಇತ್ತು, ನಾನು ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಅದು
ಸರ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಸರ್, ಈಗ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್.
ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್. But to wash your hands. ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಇದು 8 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ.
ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್, ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇರಲಿ, ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇದು ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇದನ್ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ ನಾ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ರ ಆಗದೆ ಇದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇತ್ತು. Preparation of the part is going on with an antiseptic solution and the spirit. Previously we have done the part preparation, the shaving of the particular part has been done.
After that, you can locate this abscess, and you have to find the another opening at the below that area, and you have to fluctuation test is appreciated, and another opening where it has started sinus opening is at the area. You have to locate it. From that, you can, after that, you can probe it. So priorly, you have to take out this abscess cavity under local anesthesia, which you are going to give the local anesthesia. It is to be a lignocaine, which we commonly use. It is 3 to 5 mg/kg body weight is to be calculated, and accordingly we have to infiltrate it. Particularly superficially, you have to create a wheel. After that, at the base, you have to go on either side, like what we give in routinely abscess. The same thing, infiltration will be done at a particular part. Near the opening also, you have to anesthetize the area with the local anesthesia, because you are probing. After draining the pus from that area, you are draining it. Once you confirm, you demarcate with the knife. Then you have to give a stab incision. You insert like a stab incision. You have to enter. You have to expel out all the contents of the serosanguinous. You can appreciate there the pus with the purulent discharge will be there, serosanguinous. After that, there is a purulent discharge. A pus is coming out from the cavity. You have to take out completely that one. The hairs are coming sometimes along with the tract, along with the debris and the tissue. See, I am taking out the hair, which is a long, slender hair. From that particular tract, I have taken out. I am demonstrating to our students also. If the simple abscess, you can go for cruciate incision. As we are keeping the thread, you let it open. It's enough, because it maintains the patency of the tract, and which continuously drains the pus from that opening. It you have created is another opening, natural opening at the sinuses, at the below that one dimple was there. You can probe from this area to that area. You will appreciate the tip of the probe at the sinus opening. See, it is coming out from that natural the sinus opening from this artificial which we have created. Now I am loading the thread to the eye of the probe. The probing once again confirmed. Now I am going to load the thread, the eye of the, past the thread, Shahasutra. You can able to see here, the coated thread, medicated thread, a magical thread, what you call, you have passed it, and you can tie and put a knot. So it has slipped out. Once again, I am introducing the thread into the track. Slowly, you have to put a knot. This is what the completion of the procedure. You have to put the two knots. It should not be too loose. It should not be too tight. If you put it too loose, it will create some skin abrasions on either side of the buttock due to the friction. If you put it very tight, it will create a tension and a pressure, and patient can't able to walk and patient can't able to stand. So this completes the procedure. After that, you can keep the jathyari taila pichu at the particular part. Ah, madam. Aagta idala? Kelta idala? Complete, I think. Next talk hogala namu. After the paschat karma, will be a siege bath properly for the maintenance of that particular hygiene. A jathyari taila pichu is to be kept, and maintenance of the hygiene is very important. And internal medications what give initially, if it is severe infected, we go for antibiotic course for 5 days, 5 to 7 days. Otherwise, simply we go for triphala gugulu, gandhaka rasayana, or else gandhaka rasayana, panchatikta gugulu, grutha tablet we go for. And jathyari taila application, panchavalkala or triphala parisheka will be advised for the siege bath. These are all the routine. There are certain varti prayogas in nadi rona. Varti, which will help in the faster healing of the rona, these are used especially bibitaki varti, daturadi churna varti, lavana madhu mishrita varti, and even sometimes where you can't able to do it and there are multiple things, the patient is non-cooperative. There we advise the thick kshara sutra itself, we cut into pieces and we insert into the different openings. So it helps to drain out the contents of that particular thing, and it maintains the patency. As like Kshara Sutra, we go for 7 days once thread changing, whereas in case of Varti, we go for 3 days once insertion of Varti. Sometimes we ask the patient and we educate them. You practice it in your home itself. We give Kshara Sutra with a packing, they do it. And some cases we are getting results in that also, very superficial cases. In case number one, I am taking out this foreign body of the tuft of hairs. This is after ligation. This is after complete healing of the tract. Case number two, which I mentioned, a surgeon who have operated somewhere outside, who referred to me. You can see the scar over this area. Previously operated, what you can see the procedure. After that, once again, there is a recurrence, which we did it, and patient was completely healed and he is very happy with the treatment procedures. You can able to see it. See another case with the multiple thing where we go for, we have done a complete excision of the tract will be done in this year. Here you can see this year complete with the multiple openings, and we did kshara karma. This is a complete taken out tissue. This is a shape. After application of the kshara karma, apamarga kshara, you can see the complete healing of the tract. The one of our student, Dr. Shukla, Mahashanti Shukla, who did work on this only. Nadirona, Pratsharne Kshara in Nadirona, he did it and he got excellent result, and presently is in UP. The another case with the dimple, there is a tuft of hairs I am taking out. You can see the hairs completely taken, a fourth case. This is another case with the Gugulu based Apamarga Kshara. One of the Dr. Sharad, who is doing PhD under me, who is doing the Apamarga Kshara Sutra and the Gugulu based Palasha Kshara Sutra. Comparative study he is doing. He is doing a study under me only. This is another case completely after healing. You can see the fresh wound is there. These are the hairs removed from that post-operative case. The important thing is the mode of action of Kshara Sutra in case of pilonidal sinus, in case of fistula. You can see this ice cube. Once you cut at a stretch, this will fall down with the two pieces. Once you go on cutting slowly, slowly with the fiber, like in the same way, once the ice is cut from the top to bottom, once you cut from the started cutting from the top, once you go at the bottom, again the top is connected with that this one. The same way, Kshara Sutra causes a debridement of the unhealthy tissue and excise the tract. We know that Chedana, Bedana, Lekanam, Tridoshagnatvat. Kshara will does the Tridosha Shamana and Chedana, Bedana, Lekana. All these procedures will be done by only Kshara. And also the mechanical pressure which facilitates the cutting of the tract, thus causes the complete excision. In this way,
as in case of fistula, it never damages the sphincter muscles. Step by step, fiber by fiber, in the same way, gradually which maintains the patency by keeping the thread in the track, and it gradually cuts the tissue, so you will not get the recurrence rate. The most important thing is in this disease is because of the recurrence, they become a, it become a headache. So as a, in case of Kshara Sutra, you never get this recurrence. Even in Kshara Karma also, you never get. Because once the complete excision, the remnant portion, whatever tissue is there, that will be burnt by the Kshara Karma. So you never get a recurrence. Only thing, you have to maintain the proper healing process of that one. These are the different references where we got different authors have done work on that particular Kshara Karma and in this pyelonephral sinus. The most important thing what Ayurvedic surgeons and persons pate sati gadarthasya kimoshadi nishevanam patte asati gadarthasya kimoshadi nishevanam. If you do patya, it is not necessary to take medicines. If you don't do patya, even if you take medicines also, you will not be land up, you will not be cured. So these things what I highlighted, apatya ahara, this is good for the tongue, good for the eyes, but not good for the belly and not good for the disease. So it is must to follow the patya. It is must to advise the patient to go for the patya so that he will be cured. This is very, very important in the treatment principles, whatever we did so far. This is also very important. Patya ahara is very important. Whatever I have shown in this slide is apatya ahara. Apart from this, all of the patya. The pyelonephral sinus can be considered as a shell edge and adirana, no doubt. Sushruta and Ashtangakara both clearly mentioned. The application of the Pratisaraniya Kshara curates the lateral sinus and avoids the recurrence. The Kshara Sutra procedure is a safe, effective and day care procedure. If the single opening is there, it is effectively managing. In case of multiple opening also having good result, but it takes some chances, so we can go for Kshara Karma, what we have an experience and exposure in that one. Compared to the other parallel treatment procedures, the above said procedures proved to be effective in the therapeutic, not only a therapeutic, and even in the recurrence aspect also. In case of recurrence, definitely a 99-100% result is there in both the pyelonephral sinus by Kshara Karma and Kshara Sutra. Thank you one and all. Special thanks to Dr. Das sir, the principal of the SVM Ayurvedic College, Dr. Prakash Tariwal sir, Dr. Sidhling Swami sir, Dr. Prabhudev sir, Dr. Budni doctor, and Dr. Asma and Dr. Arvind, and all the respected managing committee members of the institute, and all the respected faculty of the SVM Ayurvedic Medical College, and all the online viewers. Thank you very much. Hello.
Hello, Buddhi sir.
Hello, sir.
Buddhi sir. Any question is there? Sir, Patil sir.
Hello.
Hello. Sir, namaste. Patil
sir. Sir, namaste, sir. Sir, any complications while applying this, sir, Kshara Sutra in this pyelonephral sinus, sir?
Sir, one Nimish. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Here, sir. Namaste.
Sir, namaste. Sir, any complications while treating this pyelonephral sinus with Kshara Sutra?
Yeah, sir. If the Kshara Sutra is not prepared properly, sometimes the sensitive patients will get blisters on that particular part. Sometimes, very rarely. And if you are not doing properly this technique properly, you will land up in a complications. Otherwise, I never come across any single complication in my cases of last 16 years, sir.
Sir, one question.
Yes, sir.
What is the dose of application of Kshara after Chedra? And is there any post-op complications?
Dose of Kshara Karma?
Sir. Kshara. Dose.
It is not like that. Tikshna Kshara will be applied that particular whole area after excision of the completely the taking out the unhealthy tissue. You have to completely apply to that particular part. Wait for Shatamatra Kala. Then go for Limbu Swarasa neutralization. As routinely we are doing in Arsha Chikitsa, the same thing will be practiced here also. After that, you can go for Ropana Karma, sir, with Jatyadi Taila and other things.
Sir, one more question from Shivalila.
Yeah, sir.
If it is a diabetic patient, what the special care should be taken?
In case of diabetic patients, you have to take little bit care. You have to control the blood sugar level. Then you can go for the procedure. In that case, instead of going for this pratsarane kshara after excision, simply we can go for kshara sutra procedure in that also, provided you have to control the blood sugar level and you have to explain everything to that patient. And diet is very, very important in that diabetic patient, especially.
Sir, what is jetplasty from Chandru Kirgi?
Yeah, jetplasty is a jet-shaped incision is taken, because once you take a elliptical complete elliptical incision in that particular part, you will be losing the tissue. After losing that tissue, you can't approximate the tissue because the tension will be created. So to overcome the tension and create and attain the suturing, you have to create the Z-shaped plasty so that you can take one flap below, one flap above. So that to neutralize this one tension and reduce this and approximate the tissue, you can go for Z-shaped thing. It is a Z-plasty, sir.
Sir, one
after
more question.
After excision only we are going for that one.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. One more question from Dr. Vijayananda Hiramant.
Yeah, yeah.
What is the landmark to create artificial opening to put Kshara Sutra? Is yes, where yes, track sir. Ends on sideways like that is awesome.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No doubt many a times there will be a ramification as in case of fistula. But whereas in case of pilonidal sinus, already from that sinus, we are going for the probe. Probe is indicator for us where it is reaching maximum area, where you can able to reach. That is the landmark. You have to create another artificial opening and you have to take it out from that part and you can put the thread. For example, if the six inch length tract is there, you have started from this sinus opening, you are creating another opening at the 3 inch. The remaining that 3 inch, if you are not covering in this the thread, the it is content will be remained there itself, every chance of getting a recurrence rate in that area. So to avoid that one, you can go for at the maximum height with the help of guidance of the probe. This is very important, sir.
Sir, once some frame person, Dr. Vijayanand Hiramant is asking, is yes, a single sir. Sitting can we do ahead with incision and drainage with followed by Kshara Karma, or it is a staged surgery?
Sir, I'm not getting your question. Hello?
Sir, in a single sitting, can we do with can we go ahead with incision and drainage with followed by Kshara Karma, or it needs staged surgery?
Sir, Kshara Karma is a single only one sitting procedure only. Once you take the case completely, you have to excise it. After excision, you will go for the Kshara Karma. After that, only thing is wound dressing will be the only treatment. Only it is a one sitting procedure, one sitting procedure.
Yes, Runaropana Karma will be followed.
Yeah, yeah, sir. Ronavat Chikitsa, I highlighted in my this one.
Yes, sir.
Shodhana
yes,
will be done. After Shodhana, Ropana will be taking place with the particular medications.
Yes, sir. Sir, one more Chandru Kirgi.
Yeah.
We can try with the Kshara Taila for this pilonidal sinus.
Yeah, sir. Definitely you can try with the Kshara Taila, but the potency will be less in that one. So you can go for Kshara Karma directly. Where you can't able to do this procedure, there you can go for the Kshara Taila. It can also be done, sir. I think the base of the aisle, the potential may be less.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. One more.
Opinion from the Rasa Shastra people. From my side, this is the explanation, sir.
Yes, sir. Kshara is the better.
Sir. Where you can able to do it. There is certain sir. Area here you can't able to reach. There you can push this Kshara Taila.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir, one more.
Yes,
if hair enters, how many days are taken to show symptoms?
It is not like that enters only one single hair. Once it creates any foreign body, once it enters, once it takes a proper time to develop problems like symptoms, one hair enters, another hair enters, it creates irritation. Once it creates irritation, there will be a suppurative stage will be taking place. Exactly we can't tell the date routinely. Okay. Anything, once it happens, it will take about 10 to 14 days is a time duration what we routinely observed. They what they explain probable what you call a vulnerable time to manifest a symptom, that is a time duration we can take it out in this area, sir.
Yes sir. Thank you, sir. How to avoid this?
Which one, sir?
In our daily routine life, sir. Pilonidal sinus.
You have to maintain the hygiene at the posterior area, and you have to avoid, if you are obese individuals, you have to maintain the physique and fitness of your body. and hygiene is very important. If you are driving a vehicle regularly, you try to take a gap between the driving. For example, after 2 hours, you take rest for a few minutes, then you can drive, wash that particular area. This is what precautions you can take. Along with that, the dietary things will be followed.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, one more question from the Nivedita.
Yeah.
If there is a 3 to 4 hairs, how do we come to know we have removed the hairs completely?
Yeah, sir. For example, in case of excision, there is no question of how to remove. In case of Kshara-sutra, this is problem comes. If you are taken, for example, you imagine there are 10 hairs are there inside. First sitting, if you do the procedure, that time you will get 5 to 6 hairs. Second sitting, once you are doing, again the 5 to 6 remaining. Every time you are doing the thread changing, that knot which is taken out from inside the tract, which will take out the, all the hairs. Once the thread is inserted, it maintains the patency. Whatever collection is there, it is drained out. During that drainage, the hairs will enter and it comes out. I have shown hairs are taken with the artery. Like that, you can take. The important thing is how much hair you have taken, rather than the how much patency you are maintaining is more important than the taking out the hair, sir.
Yes. Sir, this all procedure done in only in local anesthesia?
Yes, sir. I am doing all anorectal procedure, whatever I mentioned, the number of cases I did, 99.9% I am doing under local only, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Any more questions? Students? No, sir.
Yes, sir. My special regards and thanks to you and your department colleagues and Asma and other colleagues, and especially Dr. Das sir, Tariwal sir, and Arvind, all the teaching faculty. And thank you very much, all the webinar viewers and students. Once again, my special thanks for this opportunity, Siddhling Swami sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Asma. Okay. I am very much thankful to Dr. Siddhrangoda Padil sir. It's a wonderful session regarding the definition of the pyelonodal sinus, etiology, pathology, clinical feature, diagnosis and investigation, and also treatment aspects, and also the nadi vruna and its explanation. I think almost students are enjoyed well, and they are become perfect with pyelonodal sinus and the nadi vruna, and also there's videograph also is very good, and thank also there's photographs also very good, sir, that they were teaching it's also very excellent. And really, our students are very lucky to have a speaker like you, sir. I am very much thankful to you, sir, for accepting our invitation. I am very much thankful to you, sir. Thank Dr. KC, sir, because with his support only, we are conducting all these webinar series. Thank you very much, sir. And also, I am thankful to our all department members, Dr. Chandrakant Budni, Dr. Prabhudeva, and Dr. Asma, for their wonderful efforts to conduct this webinar series. And also, I am thankful to all my teaching faculty members and the PG scholars and students, also practitioners who are attending this session. Thank you, sir. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Namaste.
Thank you, sir. Shankar Patel, Siddhrangoda Patel, sir.
Namaste. Namaste.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Chandrakant, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, end Madonna.
Thank you, Chandru.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you. Siddhrangoda Patel, sir, it is very wonderful presentation. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, sir, on the behalf of our department. I congratulate you, sir.
I thank and congratulate your department for conducting such events, which could really encourages and enriches the knowledge of the students. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Namaste. Namaste.